I didn't come all this way just to stop now. I've got to go through with it, for Sean. Don't look him in the eyes. Just shoot.
Yeah? What do you want? Ugh, fuck it. I said 1,000 times that I don't want any junkies at my door. Hey! Take it easy, man, huh? Keep cool. Dope? Money? Tell me what you need. Sure we can make a deal, huh?
God! I'm gonna blow your brains out, you son of a bitch! You think you're coming to my house and steal my dope? You'll be shooting up in hell, motherfucker!
Oh, man. Will you stop fucking moving?
Man, I give you whatever you want. Got dope? Got cash? You want some dope? Please. Please don't kill me, man. I got children. These my girls, see? This one's Sarah. And a little one. That's Cindy. Please, man. I want to see them again. Please, please don't shoot.
I'm a father too. But I'm no killer.
Gotta find some way to get him to talk about the Marble Street apartment. I'm gonna act all doped up. I hope he goes for the bait.
Hi. I was told that you could get Vitropin. Without a prescription?
Sorry, you were misinformed. Goodbye.
Hold on. I really need your help here. I can pay.
Well, why didn't you say so? Please, come in. So, you're looking for Vitropin, my dear. Are you having trouble sleeping? How much do you need?
I don't know, about 3-4 boxes.
Well, no, that shouldn't be a problem. Would you like a drink? I was just about to have one.
No, thanks.
Well, alcohol helps take the edge off the pills, don't you think? Anyway, we should drink a toast to our first deal.
I haven't seen you around here before. Who told you about me?
It's a tight neighborhood. People talk. I heard you had some apartments for rent. I'm looking.
Sorry, darling. Those are all booked up.
Shame. I was looking for something around Marble Street.
You're not drinking?
I'm not really thirsty.
I'll get your prescription. Won't be a moment. Wait here.
That guy gives me the creeps. I better take a look around to see if I can find anything before he gets back. Quick! We gotta find something. Doc seems to be interested in property, amongst other things. He seemed to be upset that I wouldn't drink. I get the feeling I did the right thing. Maybe a quick look behind those doors. I'll make up some lies if he finds me. Could the doc be the origami killer? There's something about the way he looks. Don't make a sound. He's near.
Beach came around here asking questions about the apartment on Marble Street. I don't know what you're doing now, and I don't want to know. But whatever that shit is, he's beginning to draw attention. Look, I know you kept me out of prison, but that fucking bitch nearly killed me. Everything you ask, I think my debt to you is paid. Don't fuck around, man. No. No, wait. I can still help you out. No. Don't kill me.
No time to waste. Gotta find Paco.
guy.
John. He said his name is John. Friend of Paco's. Always let him straight up.
The killer may have left some clues in the office. Shit. Looks like a dead end. Road to nowhere. He could have killed me. Why didn't he? I'll end up a basket case if things keep going like this. That bastard nearly broke my neck.
I seem to spend most of my time getting the shit kicked out of me.
It all happened so fast, didn't have time to see his face. Paco knew the killer. That's why he was killed. The suspect dead. Someone tries to kill me. On the right track, do you think? He could have killed me. Why didn't he? His coat pocket. I tore it off during the fight. Two receipts from the same gas station. Paco Mendez was no saint. His rap sheet reads like the telephone book. .45 caliber. The killer was looking for something. A bullet, right between the eyes. Instant death. Madison Page. What was a journalist doing here?
know how to do these little dogs, too. My children loved origami. I taught them how to do it. John loved the little dogs. He always wanted to call them Max. Max, Max, Max. All dogs with the same name. I was wasting my time telling him they couldn't all have the same name.
Them?
They're good little boys. Their father never looked after them. Always drinking. They didn't have an easy life, you know.
Her memory is coming back. Don't stop now. Just remember.
Does Mrs. Shepherd ever talk about her past?
It's not all very clear to her now. Sometimes she'll remember the oddest things, though. I suppose if she sees something that reminds her of her past.
I'm looking for her other son. He was adopted. I mean, he's probably changed his name. Is there any official documentation on Mrs. Shepherd?
No, there's nothing really. Nothing about her family. I guess if her son was adopted, then she's the only one who could tell you about that.
Does she get many visitors?
She's been here for 10 years and you're the first. Sometimes, if you show her things, it seems to trigger a memory from her past. You might get it to remember.
Thanks for the advice.
Show her things that take her back. Show her things that take her back. Show her things that take her back.
What a lovely orchid. My sons loved orchids. We used to grow them in the back. When John died, I laid orchids on his grave. I cried when they told me. I'd already lost one of my children, and now they were taking away another one, you understand.
The foster family, Mrs. Shepherd. What was the name of the foster family that adopted John's brother?
They were really very nice people. I met them, you know. In the beginning, I used to go and see my little boy. And then I got sick and I couldn't go any longer. Perhaps he thought I'd forgotten him. He must have thought I didn't love him anymore.
His name, Mrs. Shepherd. What was his name?
But I loved him. If you only knew how much I missed him.
Please, Anne. His name. What was his name?
Come closer.
Trial. The last question. Are you prepared to give your life to save your sons? There is a deadly poison in this file. It will kill you in exactly 60 minutes. If you drink it, you will get the last letters of the address. You will have enough time to save your son and say goodbye to him, but then you will die. You can drink the vial or decide to leave. The choice is yours.
Kill myself to save Sean? That's ridiculous. I'll find some other way. I'm sure I can save him. There's got to be another way. I can't kill myself to save my son. Save Sean and die. Christ. He loses his father, but at least he's alive. Maybe it's the right thing to do. Poison. So, if I drink this, I'll be dead in an hour, and if I don't, I won't get the last letters. He could be lying. Maybe I'll die as soon as I drink this, and then no one can save Sean. There's no choice. I've got to do it. If I want to save my son. Nothing to lose. I've come too far to stop now. Am I willing to die to save my son? The cameras. He must be watching me. 1 hour to live. Just enough time to save Sean. I'll find you, Sean. I'll figure out a way, and I'll come and get you, son.
I can't fight him!
Where are you, Sean? Where are you?
We've only got a few more hours left to save Sean Mars. There has to be a goddamn clue somewhere. It's probably staring me in the face. This kid's gonna die, and I'm going around in circles!
All packed up and ready to go?
What are you talking about?
The investigation's over. We know who did it. We no longer need your services anymore, Norman. So you can ride your files all the way back to Washington. I'd be lying if I said I was gonna miss you.
The investigation isn't over. You have absolutely nothing on Mars.
Mars is guilty. Case closed. Anyway, it's no concern of yours now. You're off the case. So pack up and fuck off.
Blake, you are an unbalanced, psychopathic asshole.
I'll take that as a compliment. Honestly, I don't give a shit what you think. I found the origami killer. Everyone's happy. End of story. Have a nice trip back, Norman.
Killer's name is here. Somewhere in this data. I just have to find it. Find it before it's too late.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you know what. It can be dangerous. Very dangerous. It'll end up killing you if you're not careful. That would be most unfortunate, sir.
Two receipts from the same gas station. Might be near the killer's home. Ugh, that doesn't get us anywhere. The killer lives in this zone. 342 people live around there. Not good enough. Gotta find a means of identifying the killer more precisely. The gun the killer left at the Blue Lagoon. Perhaps there's some way of tracing its history. Impounded in a police case 5 years ago, the gun is still supposed to be in police custody. Who checked it out? If not a cop. Ari was in record mode when I was fighting with the killer. Perhaps there's something on it. Gold watch. I'm sure I've seen this before somewhere. The watch they give for promotions to lieutenant. The killer is a cop. The sword was already in Paco's office. It's got nothing to do with the killer. Looks like the killer is a cop. Carter Blake! That would explain the dead-end investigation and his desire to frame Ethan Mars. There's only one cop in that geoprofiling zone. Gotcha. He owns a warehouse on the docks. If I'm wrong, Sean Mars is dead.
That's enough. Now I get out of here and I call the police.
So you found my little secret?
It's over, Scott. All those children killed just to find a father capable of saving his son?
Shut up! You don't understand.
There's one child left. There might still be time to save him. Let him go. Do what your father couldn't do. I can't get out. I'm gonna die, and there'll be no one to save Sean.
Don't panic. Just stay calm and think. Consciousness in a few minutes, unless I do something now. I mustn't breathe in the smoke. I don't want to die here. Not now, not like this.
The old docks, the perfect place for a killer. Let's hope I'm not mistaken. There'll be no one to save Sean Mars if I've come to the wrong place. Better be careful. The killer might be near. The rainfall has reached critical levels. There's not much time left if I want to find the kid alive. Thank you.
kid. I'll get you out of there.
Capable of giving his life for his son. And what do I get? Nothing! Nobody!
All right, Sean?
Yes. Yes, I think so. Where's Dad?
I'll call the police. They'll come and get you, okay? Agent Norman Jayden, FBI. Tell Lieutenant Blake I found Sean Mars. Send men and an ambulance immediately to 852 Theodore Roosevelt Road. Fast! Thank you.
are still at a loss as to the identity of the so-called origami killer, who currently remains at large. In a related tragedy, it was learned that the investigation has cost the life of Madison Page, a young reporter covering the origami killer story. Unfortunately, the investigation has cost the life of Norman Jaden, the FBI profiler working on the case. Jaden was killed while trying to arrest the origami killer in circumstances that remain unclear. A full police investigation is pending.
Is this where we're gonna live now?
Only if you really, really want to. Or we can keep on looking until we find something you like.
It doesn't matter where we live, as long as we're together.
I will never let anyone or anything separate us again. We're stuck with each other, kiddo. Like glue.
Can I choose what my room is?
Sure thing, champ.
All right, then I think we can stay here.
Journalist Madison Page was laid to rest in Charity Cross Cemetery today. Her heroic death while investigating the disappearance of Sean Mars has made a lasting impression on the whole country. Colleagues from the press are united in paying tribute to this courageous journalist who sacrificed her life in the search for truth. I'm Brittany Sanders for ICN.
Okay, Brittany, it's a wrap.
Great, let's get out of here. All those hokey clapcaps made me hungry.
He's being buried in 2 days in some godforsaken hole in the back end of beyond near Washington. I have to attend as a matter of protocol.
I'll pass. Jane and I didn't see eye to eye on much.
No problem. I understand.
Hey, sir, I still have his glasses. What should I do with them?
Well, you won't be needing them again. Do whatever you want with them.